I first saw Tom play at the Junior Olympics, and I think in every sport you have high school player of the year, club player of the year. He was the player of the decade. He was special, and I don't know if they have the award, but I just made it up. And coming out, he was the best. He saw the game well, and I guess the first thing that comes to mind when I think of Tom Sorensen is this. Another kill by Sorensen.
There you go, Grinberg.
Sorensen, another kill.
At 18 years old, we were at the Junior Olympics or the Olympic Fest, and Tom and I had gotten to eat at the same table. And I told him, hey, I'm committing to Pepperdine. I know you're going to Pepperdine. And for an all-star, all-American, at the level he was at, to take time out of his schedule and sit down, and I'll never forget the conversation we had, because he instilled belief in me at that point and said, hey, I'm counting on you to participate in our team, and I need you to go in and pass balls and, you know, connect with Marv, and, you know, I need you to be a part of this.
Tom was a little bit older than me. I think he was the year before I came here to Pepperdine, and the thing with Tommy, he was always known as one of the best players, and that Pepperdine's program was going to turn around just because of Tom. And so I was so excited just to be able to get on the court with him.
Tom Sorensen, 6'6", 195-pound bomber out of Racine, Wisconsin, hits 100 miles an hour.
You know, one of the things, he was so good coming out, and he had so much volleyball in him, it made me a little antsy, a little nervous, because I didn't want to screw him up. And I felt like I had to meet, the standard that he wanted, and it was awesome.
Well, first of all, I think he's the greatest hitter that's ever come to the school. I mean, he had the most pure arm swing, pure athlete, great on the court presence. He was a great leader. He brought emotion to the team. I mean, he could pull us out of a rut. I could just set him anytime. He would get a kill, and he always wanted the ball.
He watched more video than all the players combined. He was always in the office watching video, and it could be himself, it could be our team, it could be other teams and international teams, and he knew the game.
Tom, just his mechanics were perfect, jumped well, and was really a pleasure to watch.
I remember as a freshman watching some of the things that he could do from an offensive standpoint, and it was pretty amazing. And he was someone I always looked up to and respected, and he brought his A game every time he stepped on the court.
On the court, he was great. He had the most pure arm swing of anybody I've ever seen. So I was a setter, so I could just throw a ball up, even if it was less than perfect, and he would get a kill. So it was great, so I set him all the time.
We used to set him 100 times and he'd get 40 or 50 kills. And I remember one match that we had split games with this opponent, and Chip McCaw, our setter, said, heck with this. And he set every ball for the next three games to Sorensen. Every ball, front row, back row, good pass, medium pass. And I didn't change the course because it was working. And so he was special.
Well, Tom was very easy to play with, a very easygoing, mellow guy, but he always got it done. And he was probably our most talented offensive threat. If we were in trouble, we'd set it to Tom and he'd put the ball away. And we could always rely on him to put that ball away whenever we're in trouble.
You know, we always talk about teams, and you need a good team to go far. You need special players to go far. And we had one in Tom, and it wasn't a fluke that we win the national championship with an ace by Sorensen.
Match point for Pepperdine. Sorensen serving. That's it! An ace by Sorensen has given Pepperdine the championship.
We always talk about that team and how special it was, and you know, he was our horse and we rode him and we all played our roles, and you know, I'll never forget the year of 92, that's for sure.
He was such a great player, just a natural volleyball player, and he got it done, and I'll tell you what, we wouldn't have won that national championship in 1992 without Tom.
What does it mean to a kid from Racine, Wisconsin to win the NCAA title?
This is what I've been working for 7 years, and Heck, my job was easy out there. The passers passed great, the setters set great. All I had to do was hit. It was easy with those guys out there.
Based on what he did on and off the court while he was here, I think he deserves to be in the Hall of Fame.